Hey guys, got a good one out here for you. This is Rambo. I'm getting his paperwork out right here. Registered Rocky Mountain, that tears his papers. Got the gold seal. Those of y'all that don't know much about Rocky Mountains, if you're new to the breed, always look for this seal when you're buying one, okay? Whether it's a gelding, mare, stallion, this seal is important. It is, but it ain't. Like, if you got a gelding, it don't really matter because that seal just means that this horse can breed, okay? He's certified to breed. It doesn't really matter, I guess, per se, on a gelding because nobody's going to be breeding a gelding, right? But this seal, if you're new to the Rocky Mountain horses, this seal means that this horse has met all standards of the Rocky Mountain horse. Okay? Now, I'm not saying horses without this doesn't meet the standards, but I'm saying if you're new to the breed and you don't really know what you're looking for in a horse, look for this seal. This seal should be a comfort zone for you as a new buyer. Okay? If you're new to the breed, and you're saying, okay, I want me a Rocky Mountain. I've been looking at them a while. Look for this seal, okay? That should give you some comfort. Now, I don't look for the seal when I buy horses, but I'm a horse trainer. I don't care about this seal. I can get this seal, maybe. I look at the horse, okay? I can get this seal if the horse fits, you know. What I'm very knowledgeable of what I'm doing without trying to brag. So I don't care about this seal. You, as a buyer, should care about the seal. I get this seal. I try to on all my horses. It's valuable. Anyway, this horse is certified, ready to go. His registered name is Low Down Ramblin' Rambo. His date of birth is April 27, 2013, so that means he is April. He turned, not the best at this, nine? He's 9 years old. Is that right? Yeah, April 27, 2013, 9 year old. Out of VBF, Lucky Rio, goes back to Madison River Prince. Very popular horses. Dam is Miss Jasmine. Goes back to a real popular horse called Yankee Clipper. All the way back on this horse, all the way back on the pedigree side of this horse, all the way is filled out. There's no unknown horses. A lot of horses have an unknown pedigree. When they start getting on back in the grandsires and all that, they start getting unknown. And back in the day, you could get, you know, other horses filtered in. This horse is full as they come, okay? He's got a very, very nice pedigree. It shows, too, the quality of horse we got here. This horse is 14.3 hands tall. He's slick. He's fat. He's pretty. He's stocky. This horse is broad. He's a big, bold-chested horse. He'll pack a man like me, two men like me, all day long. I mean, this horse is broke. He is beginner-proof. He is bomb-proof as one can come. If there's ever been such thing as a bomb-proof horse, right here he stands. This horse is broke, gentle, docile, built like a German tank, pretty as a picture. I mean, a nice son of a gun. Prime, 9 years old, he's prime. 14.3 hands tall. That's the number one high-selling horse in the nation right now. 14.3 in my book. Rocky Mountain, jet black, gorgeous son of a gun. I mean, he's crow black. He's black as black. He can turn him out. I've never seen this horse fade. He's always been black. They've showed this horse. They've done everything in the world with him. Now, a lot of you are going to say, well, why would anybody get rid of such a good horse? Well, now, this lady is a good client of mine. Been friends with her for a long time. I've worked horses for her for a long time, including this horse. The video you're going to see is an old training video that I've done on this horse several years ago. It might have been maybe 2 years ago. I don't know. And back before that, he showed up at a clinic that I had. Of course, like I said, I've trained for this woman for years. And she's traveling a lot. She's a nurse. She's got new jobs and she's just downsizing on horses. That is it. She does got some young stock coming up that she's going to be focusing on a little bit more. And she just downsizing on her horses. This old horse is just standing there. She's not using him. She called me up and wanted to know if I wanted him. I said, yeah, I'd like to have him. So I bought him. He is a good son of a gun. He will come with an EWH guarantee. Welcome to come try him, ride him. You don't like him, you don't own him. We're going to sell him Monday night. Now, you will be looking at a video that's a couple years old, but it's the same daggone horse, maybe even better. I'm light-handed this week. My barn help's sick or got all kinds of issues, whatever it is. I got all my help. I got one guy that he'll be here cleaning stalls. I'm going to be out tomorrow too, which will be Wednesday. I don't have anybody to work. Even if I was here, I might find somebody to video me. So what I'm trying to say is I might get better videos throughout the week, and I might not. This might be all we got. But you can see everything about him right here. My little boy rode him barebacking up in a halter down the road yesterday. He don't need a refresher. He rode right off. I don't know if it's been a while since he's been ridden or not, but you can't tell it. This is that kind of horse. You don't have to ride him every day. Ride him once a year if you want to. He will be the same horse every time you get him out. He is as good as they come. He really is. Guys, this is Rambo. Get in on him. You ain't gonna regret it. You will regret it if you let him slip through. He is a good one. Guys, I'm sorry for the little Trump flag. I really am. I would never use that on a for sale video. Well, I did actually. I sold Pablo with one. I'll never do it again, put that way. It was literally a teaser. The lady that, which is a good client of mine, good friend of mine, the lady that owned this horse, hates Trump. She hates him. I like him. She hates him. But we're still friends, and that's how it should be. But it was a teaser, just a kind of a poke at her. That was her graduation video when I done the little Trump flag. It was just a joke. Please don't get offended by it, but there you go. I just wanted to explain why there's a Trump flag in my for sale video. People put me on bad horsemanship reviews and everything else because I'm an Orange Man supporter or what have you. The fact of the matter is the horse done good with a flag flying above his head. That's all you need to know. But it was just, at the time, it was a poke at the owner. It was just a joke between us. So don't pay no attention to that.
American girls and American guys, we'll always stand up and salute. We'll always recognize when we see old glory flying. There's a lot of men dead, so we can sleep in peace at night when we lay down our heads. My daddy served in the army. We lost his right eye, but he flew a flag out in our yard till the day that he died. He wanted my mother, my brother, my sister and me to grow up and live happy in the land of the free. Now this nation that I love is falling under attack. A mighty sucker punch came flying in from somewhere in the back. Soon as we could see clearly through our big black eye, man, we lit up your world like the 4th of July. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list. And the Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist. And the eagle will fly, and it's gonna be here when you hear Mother Freedom start ringing her bell. And it'll feel like the whole wide world is raining down on you. I brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue. This big dog will fight when you rattle his cage. And you'll be sorry that you mess with the U.S. of A. 'Cause we'll put a boot in your ass, it's the American way. Hey, Uncle Sam, put your name at the top of his list. And the Statue of Liberty started shaking her fist. And the eagle will fly, and it's gonna be hell when you hear Mother Freedom start ringing her bell. And it'll feel like the whole wide world is raining down on you. I'll brought to you courtesy of the red, white, and blue.